Sometimes when you look at the new products and services, you can spot trends, you can see the shifts in the industry. And for me, what I'm looking at here is one of those. Hello, my name's Mark Egan, and over the last year, I've been working with broadcasters all over the world, trying to help them create quality content during lockdown, often from people's homes. Now, for many of them, understanding the apps and the accessories and using a smartphone has allowed them to do that. But there's been one use case that's been causing a problem. You see, if you are a news reporter, you can broadcast from home or anywhere you like with your phone, a tripod, a microphone, and you'll be able to speak to the studio and the studio can speak back to you. It gets more complicated though when we talk about news anchors. So these are people presenting a program or part of a program. Because for them, it's not just a matter of sending their video and maybe hearing some questions. They need to see what's happening in the program. They may need to read some kind of teleprompter, and the script on that teleprompter might be changing by the second as there's breaking news. And up until now, what many people have been doing is creating these kind of Frankenstein rigs with arms and monitors sticking out everywhere. The problem with that is big, it's complicated, you often need a broadcast engineer to install it, and good luck if you're living at home with kids running about. And that's why I was interested when Dejero asked if I'd like to test out their new LivePlus for Windows. And that's what I was showing you here. So what exactly is it? Well, in short, it means you could make an entire TV program with people feeding you scripts and seeing what's going on the program, all from your home on something like this. It's almost like the ultimate mobile journalism. Now I've got this loaded onto a Microsoft 7 Surface Plus, but if you've got a Windows laptop, which is post 2015, i5, a decent spec, basically something that doesn't belong in a museum, then this should work fine for you. So you can set this up any way you like, but essentially you can see what's going on the program in one window, you can see yourself, so you'll have a kind of confidence monitor, and you'll have something like a teleprompter. So if there's a script and somebody somewhere else could be feeding that script to you, changing it, updating it, controlling it, and this will allow you to set this up how you want. And then you can do your program, you can read your scripts, you can do everything just using this. Now, to be honest, lots of this stuff traditionally is beyond my level of expertise, but I actually was able to set it up. You can drag the windows however you want them to be. And in a sense, you could, if you wanted to, just use the absolute basics and make a program with this. But most people are likely to attach an external camera to it using something like a Blackmagic capture card. You could make this as big or as simple as you like. So you could have something simple, a simple camera plugged in and the microphone from the camera feeding it in, or you could get a bigger setup and you could even drag some of these windows onto other monitors if you wanted to have a proper teleprompter or something. I said earlier that this is a sign of a wider trend, and I think what lockdown has shown us is that we need to be able to create broadcast programs from home. So just finally, my prediction is that these kind of technologies like LivePlus for Windows won't be just around for lockdown. So the challenge to program makers is not just to use this to replicate exactly what we did in the past, but just in a simpler, more efficient way, but also to try and think of ambitious, creative ways to make programs in a way that we were never able to before.